Leia here from leiafirstsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, we're going to look at the mole concept in Avogadro's number. What is a mole? We're not referring to the little rodent, and we're not referring to that thing that can show up on your skin, and definitely not referring to a spy, though that would make a fun chemistry video. No. In general chemistry, a mole is just a big number. A very, very, very big number. According to Google, a mole is the mass of a substance containing the same number of fundamental units as there are atoms in exactly 12.000 grams of carbon-12. Ouch, right? This is why the topic scares so many students. It sounds overwhelming. But if you think of it as just a big number and understand the math, the entire thing becomes so much easier. Let's take a step back. Say I tell you I have a pair of shoes. You're thinking, I have two shoes. If I tell you that I have a dozen eggs, you're thinking, I have 12 eggs. If I tell you I have a gross of pencils, you may recognize that I have 144 pencils. And if I tell you I have a mole of carbon atoms, you should recognize that I have 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd carbon atoms. Or for the MCAT, just 6 times 10 to the 23rd. Because on the MCAT, close enough is good enough. The concept is simple. The math is also pretty simple. It's the story behind it that confuses students. The number 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd is also referred to as Avogadro's number, which you'll sometimes see written as N sub A or N sub 0. This is to honor the Italian scientist and lawyer, Avogadro, who helped us understand the molecule-volume relationship, specifically that equal volumes of a gas under the same conditions will have the same number of molecules, but don't worry about it now because you'll cover it in detail in MCAT physics. So what does this number tell us? The backstory, the confusing part, is something you don't even need to know for the MCAT as long as you know the takeaway. But in summary, say I tell you about carbon-12. This is a specific isotope of carbon, the most abundant isotope of carbon, that has a mass of 12 atomic mass units. If we do the math, carbon has 6 protons. This isotope of carbon has 6 neutrons. Each of these weigh 1 atomic mass unit, giving us a total mass of 12 AMU. But if I want to use 12 AMU as a small scale and 12 grams on the large scale, I weigh out 12 grams of carbon, which is mostly carbon-12. How many atoms do I have? If I weigh out 12 grams of carbon-12, we'll end up with a ridiculous amount of carbon atoms, specifically 602214085700000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000 the math would be insane. Thankfully, we have a much easier way to look at this. First of all, we turn it into scientific notation. Remember, we have an invisible decimal at the end of the last zero. So if we move it all the way over here, what do we get? 6.02. Ignore the other numbers. In fact, on the MCAT, we can even just call it 6. Times 10 to the what power? To the 23rd power, because I had to move the decimal 23 spaces over to the left. But more than scientific notation, we can just refer to this entire thing as one mole. And that makes life so much easier. One mole of any atom on the periodic table will give you the number of grams specified on the periodic table. If I take one mole of iron, I will get 55.845 grams of iron. If I weigh out 22.99 grams of sodium, I will get one mole of sodium. If I weigh out 32 grams of sulfur, I'll get one mole of sulfur. And if I weigh one mole of bromine, I will get 79.904 grams of bromine. So even though one mole is equal to 6 times 10 to the 23rd atoms, or one mole of molecules is 6 times 10 to the 23rd molecules, the substance itself is different. It's unique to what it is. Sodium, very different from iron, very different from sulfur, very different from bromine. Think of our initial example. If I gave you a dozen papers, eggs, and pencils, those are each 12 of something, but they're so different. Good luck drawing on your dozen papers with a dozen eggs. Very messy compared to the pencils, right? They're unique and therefore very different. And that should be your takeaway for the MCAT. In fact, calculating the number of atoms in a mole, or how many moles for a certain number of atoms, is less likely to show up on the MCAT compared to what we get out of it. And what we get out of it is molar mass or molecular weight calculations. That is what you have to master on the MCAT. Now, we've already done some of that in the previous video on molar mass, so let's look at some simple conversions. But first, try a logical question. Which has more atoms? 2 grams of carbon or graphite that has 1 times 10 to the 15th carbon atoms? We can't compare grams of carbon to carbon atoms because they're completely different units. The typical MCAT student instinct is to do the math to figure it out, which you can, but it's a waste of time. See if you can think it through logically before applying a calculation. What do we know about the relationship between carbon atoms and mass of carbons? We know that 12 grams of carbon is equal to 6 times 10 to the 23rd atoms. If we have 2 grams of carbon, 2 of 12 is a sixth, so we have a sixth of this number. 6 times 10 to the 23rd divided by 6 gives me 1 times 10 to the 23rd, which is way, way larger than carbon atoms on the order of 10 to the 15th. Remember that every factor represents a unit of 10, so we're dealing with a much, much larger amount of carbon in just 2 grams of carbon atoms. Let's solve this mathematically to prove it to make sure that you understand by converting the 2 grams to atoms of carbon. We'll solve it using the given times ratio method that I teach in the conversion series linked below, where our given is 2 grams of carbon, and the ratio compares mass of carbon to atoms of carbon. We put grams of carbon on the bottom so that the units can cancel, giving me atoms at the top. Then plug in the numbers, giving me 6 times 10 to the 23rd atoms divided by 12, no units because we cancel that. Our answer is going to be in the unit of atoms. And now we do the math. But we really don't do the math, because on the MCAT, always try to simplify before doing a calculation. 6 and 12 both divide by 2. That gives me 1 over 2, and guess what? 2 and 2 cancels, giving me the final math of 1 times 1 divided by 1, times 10 to the 23rd as we already predicted, which once again is way greater than 1 times 10 to the 15. Let's try a more mathy problem. Say I asked you to find the number of atoms in 0.67 moles of water. Once again, we want to set this up as a given times ratio, where the given is 0.67 moles of H2O. What's a ratio? What are we converting here? We know that 1 mole is 6 times 10 to the 23rd, but that's not enough. 1 mole of water is 6 times 10 to the 23rd water molecules. We are asked for the number of atoms, so we need a second ratio, where every 1 H2O is equal to 3 atoms. 2 atoms of hydrogen and 1 of oxygen. So that means we add a second ratio into our setup. Our given has units of mole H2O, so let's set up the ratio moles of H2O, where we know that 1 mole of H2O is equal to 6 times 10 to the 23rd molecules of water. And the next ratio, where we take just 1 H2O, 1 molecule of water, is equal to 3 atoms. Water molecules cancel, moles of water cancel, giving us a final answer in unit of atoms, which is what we were looking for, with a math of 0.67 times 6 times 3. Looks scary, but ask yourself, are there any patterns here that I recognize? 0.67 is a decimal that you should instantly recognize as 2/3. So what we really have is 2 over 3 times 6 times 3, The threes cancel, and you should be able to do this in your head, but I'm drawing it out to show you. The threes cancel, giving me 2 times 6, which is 12, times 10 to the 23rd atoms. This is improper scientific notation, so we do the move the decimal trick, taught in the math video link below. We make 12 smaller, giving us 1.2, and 23 bigger, giving us 10 to the 24th, for a final answer of 1.2 times 10 to the 24th atoms. For even more practice on this topic and stoichiometry in general, first, give this video a thumbs up, then try the stoichiometry and reactions practice quiz on my website, layerforsci.com/reactions.